Hi, welcome to day 5 of Connection with Dementia Using Instruments. My name is Kathy Lindberg. I'm a board certified music therapist in Ohio and the owner of Melisma Music Therapy Services. So I'm so excited that not that this series has ended, but that we've had a great week together and I've shown you some great instruments to use with people who are living with dementia and Alzheimer's disease. This last day, day 5, I'm going to share a variety of rhythm instruments with you, and I'm going to share a little bit about why I like each instrument. So I think I've talked to you throughout the week about one of the goals that I often use with people that I work with is to use sensory stimulation with them. So one of the ways that I like to do that, especially for visual stimulation, is I like to use instruments that are pleasing to the eye. So lots of different colors, vibrant colors. I like to use instruments that are brightly colored and have a variety of colors that catch the eyes of those I'm working with, as well as instruments that provide different types of sounds. So the first instrument I'm bringing to you is this lovely instrument. It is called a lollipop drum, and I'm sure I don't need to tell any of you why they call it a lollipop drum. It looks like a lollipop, and so does the mallet that it comes with. And I really like this instrument for the obvious reason that there are lots of colors in here, and they swirl, and there's movement to the visual head of the drum, and depending on how you hit it, it has different sounds. So one of the songs I always think about when we pull out the lollipop drums is the lollipop song, so I'm going to do a little bit of that. So we're going to sing, lollipop, lollipop, boo, lolly, 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 lollipop, lollipop, boo, lolly, 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 lollipop, lollipop, boo, lolly, 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 lollipop, lollipop. Okay, so lollipop drums. That's what that one is called. The next instrument I have is actually, I'm going to show you several in a line. The line of instruments, now I got this years ago when my kids were little, and then when they grew out of using these instruments, I just scooped them up from my kids and I put them in my practice and I use them with my clients. The line of instruments is called bambino in musical instruments, and each instrument in the line is shaped and decorated to be a different animal. So I'm going to show you some of the instruments that I have in the line. It came with maracas that look like frogs. So there are lots of ways you could use this. You could have conversations with people. You could, especially nonverbal people, you could have a conversation depending on how they shook the instrument and used the face of the frog on the maraca to play. The line also came with a line of jingle bells. Some look like frogs, and some look like monkeys, and a lot of people just think this looks like a bear. So it's kind of a fun instrument to pull out and have people guess what kind of animal they think these are. So the jingle bells. It also came with a line of, if I can reach here, tambourines. Now they used to have heads. Plastic heads in here to tap, but somewhere along the way, the heads in the body of the instrument got ripped. So I just ripped them out so that because they had sharp edges, and so now it's just a hollow hole. Penguins and bears. Lots of ways to play these, and again, they're visually stimulating, and they're just fun. The other type of, I also have a different, this was not actually in the line of bambino instruments, but I have tambourines that look like swans or ducks or maybe even birds, doves as well. Again, brightly colored red, lots of ways to hold it for people that may have impairments with their hands or their grip. And then again, it's the body of an animal, makes it kind of fun. Okay, I also like to just grab instruments that just look fun and have different textures to them. So this is just a rattle shaker. And if you can see, it's like a wicker basket material. So again, different feels, different textures, different sounds, depending on how you play them. I love to bring this instrument in. This is called a cabasa. And you can see that it's got rings of metal beads on them. Now, there are several ways to play this. Probably the most common way to play this is to just move the beads back and forth to make a sound. But you can also, depending on the people you're working with, their ability to move their wrist, you can twist your wrist, or even shake it for a more subtle sound. So for this instrument, I always think of this song when we pull this instrument out. Let's see. Down the way where the lights are gay and the sun comes shining on the mountaintop. I took a trip on a sailing ship, and when I reached Jamaica, I had to stop. So I'm sad to say, I'm on my way. Won't be back for many a day. My heart is down, my head is turning around. I had to leave a little girl in Houston Town. Okay, that's called a cabasa. I also have a pair of claves, which, while they're not brightly colored, they are fun and they make a nice, interesting sound. Now, a lot of people take claves and they hold them like rhythm sticks and they hit them together. And that works, but actually the proper way to play a clave is to cup your hand and put one clave in the cup of your hand so that there is space underneath it. You probably can't see because of the angle of my hand. And then hit or tap with the other clave. It's a much richer sound. Now, for people who like to hold their claves together and hit them, I like to use true rhythm sticks. I buy them in a variety of colors, again, for visual stimulation. You can also use them with activities in terms of mixing and matching your colors, if you have a group and everybody has a certain color, you can do call and response and give direction to people with a certain color rhythm stick of playing them, but they're more traditional. You just hit them together. Like that. Now, sometimes I go and find fun instruments at the dollar store. So, you know, you don't have to spend a lot of money to find instruments that are visually appealing and fun. I went to the dollar store one year around St. Patrick's Day, and I found green clapper hands, and they were very inexpensive, obviously, at the dollar store. And all you do is flip your wrist and have your hand slap, clap. You can also use them as a regular hand. So if you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, then your face will surely show it. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. Okay, lots of different ways to use this. People can tap them on their legs or on their arms. Like I said, hands. Shake them in the air. I always tell residents, just don't hit your neighbor unless they say it's okay. Okay, the final instrument that I have to show you today, I don't know that it has a proper name, but it is a little rhythm pig. I've seen them as frogs as well. Okay, so not only is he fun to talk about, you know, you pull him out, you talk about him, but he's got a ridged back here, kind of like a, I don't know, whatever has a ridged back. My brother's Rhodesian Ridgeback has a ridged back. So, he comes with a little mallet as well, and one of the ways to play him is to take the mallet and rub it along his ridge. But you can also take the mallet and tap him, similar to the clave that I was holding, is hold him in your hand. Very easy. But just a fun and interesting instrument to use. So, I hope those gave you some ideas for simple rhythm instruments. You know, there are also things online where you can learn how to make your own instruments. It doesn't have to be an expensive endeavor, but I do encourage you, especially when you're working with folks with Alzheimer's and dementia, to make them as visually appealing as possible. Nice bright colors, different shapes, different textures, because sensory stimulation is an important goal for these folks as you're working with them, especially as the disease process progresses. So if you've missed any of the videos this week, you can see them all by visiting my page on Facebook and going back and watching the videos. I've also uploaded all of them to my YouTube channel, which is Melisma Music. You can see them there as well. And finally, if there's anybody who you think would enjoy these videos, I encourage you and ask you to share. No, Chuck, I don't have bongos, and I forgot to bring the tubano out, didn't I? So that'll have to be another series where I bring out my big tubano drum, similar to a djembe, for those of you who know anything about African drums, but you should have reminded me earlier, so sorry about that. But like I was saying, please feel free to share this video. I'd like to reach as many people as I possibly can, giving them ideas of working with folks with dementia and using instruments. So thanks for taking some time this week and joining me for this series. And let me know what you thought in the comments. And look forward to future series soon. Thanks.